Hello guys, today we are going to study about the CCNA RNS. Myself Himanshu, and I have done CCNA Security, CCNA Routing Switching, CCNP Routing and Switching, and CCI Routing and Switching. And I'm also hold expertise in the F5 load balancer. Okay, so let's start the today's topic, that is the VLAN. Okay, so first of all, what are the VLANs and why do we use them, right? And how the traffic inside the VLAN flows. Okay, so VLANs, the meaning of the VLANs is virtual area network. We used it to segregate the layer 2 broadcast domain. As you know, by default, whole of the switch, all of the port of the switch are in the VLAN 1 and they share the same broadcast domain. So if we want to segregate the broadcast domain, so we need to create the VLANs. Okay? And if two ports are the part of the same VLAN and the traffic inside them, we want to see how the traffic flows inside the same VLANs, it is actually layer 2 switched. Okay? If the traffic wants to go outside of the VLAN, right, or two VLANs want to communicate with each other, do the inter VLAN communication, then we need a layer 3 device. The layer 3 device can be router or it can be the switch, but it needs to be a layer 3 switch. Okay, so let's move on to the next slide. Once we create the VLAN, okay, so the VLAN has been divided into two categories. One is the normal ranges of VLAN, right? One is the extended ranges of VLAN. And one more thing is that some VLANs are by default are present onto the switch, right? For example, VLAN 1, VLAN 1002 to VLAN 1005, right? And VLAN ID, in the frame, there is a 12-bit field for the VLAN ID. So maximum number of VLAN that we can form is the 4096. But as 0 and 4095 have been reserved as per the 802.1Q standardization, okay, so we are only able to use VLAN 1 to VLAN 4094, right? So let's talk about the normal range of VLAN. Normal ranges of VLAN is from 1 to 1005. But as the VLAN 1 is reserved and VLAN 1002 to 1005 is reserved, so we would be only be able to create VLAN 2 to VLAN 1001. And the extended range of VLAN is from the 1006 to 4094. Okay. As we have already discussed regarding the VLANs, so let's move on to the another slide.
So can we create a VLAN more than 4095?
As you know, the VLAN ID field is 12 bit long, so we would not be able to create VLAN more than 4094 as the field doesn't support itself. Okay. So regarding the creation of the VLAN, how can you create the VLAN? We have two options. Okay, if we want to create the VLAN, we have the two options. One, we can do it in the privilege mode, or you can say the enable mode, by going into the VLAN database. Okay, another method is via global configuration mode. Okay, so even you will see that latest softwares or the later operating system of the switches will not support the VLAN database mode or configuration of the VLAN through the enable mode or privilege mode. Okay. And how, when we create the VLAN, okay, and the VLAN information is stored into the flash. Running configuration is stored into the NVRAM, but the VLAN configuration is stored into the flash as a VLAN.dat file, that is known as VLAN database file. Okay, so let's move on to the another slide. Now, once we create the VLAN, now the thing is, the next step is to assign the port or assign the membership of the ports to the created VLAN. Okay, so when we have the three options, right? We have the switch ports mode are three. One is the access mode, another one is the trunk mode, and another one is the dynamic switch ports. So what are these access ports? When you want a port should be only a member of a single VLAN, then you make that port as an access port. Okay, trunk, generally between switches, the link is configured as trunk. So the trunk is used to carry the multiple VLANs traffic. And the dynamic switch port, the work of the dynamic switch port is to automatically choose whether the port is going to become an access or trunk. Right? So let's move to the practical CLI. So this is going to be the logical topology on which we are going to work. We have two switches. Let's see. We have two switches, switch one and switch two. Let's assign it a host name, switch one. Now let's try to form the VLAN, create the VLAN onto the VLAN database mode. So you will type VLAN database and it will show you the warning. It will show you the warning that it is not recommended to create the VLAN onto the privilege mode. Okay, then you have to simple write the VLAN name, for example VLAN 3. Okay, you want to create a VLAN 4, then simple give the name VLAN 4, then type apply and then exit. Now you have created the VLAN and you want to see the VLAN has been created or not. Simple, you have to type show VLAN command and you will be able to see the VLAN with name 3, VLAN with name 4 and VLAN with name 10 has been created.
What is VLAN 1?
Basically VLAN 1 is a default VLAN and you will also see when we will move on to the further classes that it is a native VLAN. So that if we form the trunk, the data when flows through the native VLAN, when data is, the traffic is originated from the native VLAN, it is untagged when it is carried through the trunk.
Okay. Why do we have so many other VLANs configured?
So basically we have four VLANs, that is FDDI and it is written as TR-BRF. So these VLANs are, one is for the fiber distributed, and another one is the for the token ring technology. These technology you will not see today, they are obsolete, they have become the legacy. Okay, they have become the legacy, so you will not be able to see them, right? So let's move on. So these are the VLAN that we have created, 3 and 4. And let's go and now configure the VLAN with the global configuration mode. So you have to go into the global configuration mode with the conf-t command and then simple type VLAN, let's say 11. And you can also give it a name. Let's say I'm giving it a name of marketing. Okay, and exit. Now you want the VLAN, for example, the ranges of VLAN to be formed. For example, I want to form 12 to 20. So automatically the VLAN 12 to 20 will be formed. You can see that, check it out from the enable mode to the show VLAN command. With this command you will be able to see that I have created, with a single command I have created the VLAN from 12 to 20, right? And you can also create the VLAN like this with comma 30 or 40, exit. You can also create it using this command so that not on the range, for example, you want to create 10, 20 and 30, not like 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So you can use this one. So with a single command, you will be able to create the 3 VLANs at a time or 4 VLANs at a time. Okay, now the things come to check the switch ports. Okay, so there is a really simple command, show interface switch port. So first of all, let's see about what this command means and what are the output means. So the first output is this, is the name of the interface. Second one is the switch port. Switch port enabled, when you will see the enabled, it means this port is working as a layer 2 port. Okay, then it has the administrative mode. By default, you will see the switches are in the dynamic mode. Either it is going to be dynamic auto or it is going to be dynamic desirable. It is actually platform dependent. Dependent on the platform of the switch, right? Then then here you will see the negotiation of trunking is on. We will study about it later, but it means that DTP is working on the switch port. Now if you type under this, going into the interface, and you type no switch port, then you have upgraded the port from the layer 2 to layer 3. Okay, but now our switch port is working as a layer 2, so you will see the switch port as enabled. And if you want to see the particular, regarding the particular interface, you can type this command show interface, then specify the interface name, and then type switch port. Then you will be able to see only that interface layer 2 attributes. Right, so let's now assign the interface to a VLAN. So I'm going to assign interface 0/0 to the VLAN, let's say VLAN 10, and I would make it first access port so that it would be a part of only a single VLAN. So simple type switch port mode access. So with this command, it is going to be a part of single VLAN, and then you are going to type assign it towards the specific VLAN, switch port access VLAN. That's, I'm going to assign it to the VLAN 10. So switch port access VLAN 10. Now you want to check it whether it has been assigned or not. So there is a very simple command, show VLAN brief. So as you are able to see, the interface Ethernet 0/0 has been assigned to the VLAN 10. Okay. So that's it. Hope you understand regarding the VLAN and how to assign the ports to the VLAN. Thank you.